Today we're coming to you from the prairie. Hi everyone, welcome to the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service's Conservation Connect. I'm Chelsea McKinney and today we're going to explore conservation careers, awesome animals, and all kinds of technology that conservation professionals use to study and help wildlife. Today I'm coming to you from Sevilleta National Wildlife Refuge in New Mexico. Joining us today, we have Ariel Elliot, a researcher at the University of Tennessee who is studying small mammals here at Sevilleta. Ariel, thank you so much for having us at this amazing refuge, and what beautiful prairie you have.
Thank you for coming down.
I'm wondering, what is the best part of your job?
The best part of my job is being out here. This is my office, and it's pretty amazing, expansive, and I see new things every day.
What kinds of techniques are you using to study small mammals? Can you show us what exactly do you do here?
Yeah, I can show you out in the field. Come with me.
All right, let's go. We started by checking some of Ariel's small mammal traps.
And you like peer inside. Little pocket mouse.
You got one.
So cute. So then I just usually just like get my bag out.
Okay.
You have to like wrap it around the corners to make it tight so they don't escape out.
Sure.
Just do a little swoop and into the bag they go. Twist it. Weigh them. This one weighs 19 in the bag.
How much does the bag weigh?
The bag weighs 8.
8, okay.
And there's not a lot of food in here, so you know that the bag would be minus 8. Kind of squish them into the corner. You just grab their scruff.
Yep.
Like you would a cat.
Yep, like a kitten or a puppy.
And there you have it. Oh, that's so cute. It's a silky pocket mouse. And then I'd usually just mark them to show that they were captured. Okay. Black is for the first knife capture.
The first capture. So you put that on the body.
Yeah, I give them a little vest.
So if we capture another one that has black, that means you've captured it at least one other time.
Yes.
And what does that tell us?
It's if you capture enough of like the black ones, that means it was a recapture, meaning you can tell population size.
So I can estimate a population size based on how many I recapture that have the black markings.
Yes.
What do we have?
We have a wood rat.
A wood rat. Whoa, that thing is not small. Refuge biologist John Erz assisted in processing this wood rat.
Let's weigh it. $168. Yep, a fancy New Year piercing. Gonna be really cool.
Then we released this little guy.
There we go.
Now it was time for me to get some hands-on experience weighing a kangaroo rat.
All right, okay, we gotta weigh it.
So I'm gonna weigh it.
It.
You got the scale.
Twist.
This one has a tail.
Yes. That's good.
All right. What do we got? Looks like 64. Once I finished my measurements, I set him free. Thank you. Ariel, can you tell me more about small mammals? What kinds of species you're finding in these traps? And then why you find them so interesting?
I find them interesting because they're small and they're really adorable. And it's just like there's so many of them. You wouldn't suspect because it's like nothing's out here, but there is. There's a desert, but it's full of life. And the types of species that I get are kangaroo rats, basically, and the small pocket mouse that you saw earlier.
Now you have the coolest job. Students that are going into school, what kinds of things should they be doing to get a job as cool as yours?
Just get out there, go talk to your professors and your teachers, just go out for activities that are outdoors.
Thank you, Ariel, so much for showing us around Sevilleta National Wildlife Refuge and this amazing prairie that you have.
Thank you for coming, but you haven't really seen it all yet. This is just a small part of it.
It's really amazing when we can combine our love of wildlife, the beautiful outdoors, and the techniques of catching small mammals to help protect our fish, wildlife, and our beautiful places. We'll see you guys next time on the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service's Conservation Connect.